Hello guys, my name is Joel Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at JT Devs. For today's video, we're going to start with some examples on typecasting and user input using C# in 2022. Let's define typecasting. It's a way of converting one data type to another. We have different type of casting, implicit casting, and explicit casting. With implicit casting, allow us to convert a small size of a data type to a large one. So when we're talking about small data type, we're referring to the size of inside of a memory that will be allocated to a particular data type. For character, I believe it has 1 byte. Integer has 4 bytes. Double, I believe it should be around 6 bytes or above. All right. So you see, that's why we have, so in this example, I'm going to make use of integer with double. Okay, so we're going to create an integer value, so we can say int bonus, or maybe we can just say int salary equals to 45,000, and then we want to convert this integer value to double. So we say double. So we can say d salary equals to salary, and then this is going to be how to convert, to make use of implicit casting. Okay, so now let's display our value console.format. This is JavaScript console.writes. Line, then we can specify d salary. So let's run our program to see the output. We're going to type .net run, and then you press enter. We just have to wait for a bit. If there's any error, you will see some red line, and if not, then the result will be displayed. Okay, so we got our feedback. So now let's about the explicit casting. So it's going to allow us to convert large data type to a small one. So in this case, I'm going to make use of start with double salary equals to 45,078 cents. Right. Then we want to convert it to int. Convert. Then we have int. Int. I salary, I for integer. Then we have to convert double to integer. To do so, we need to say convert dot to int. So we it has int 16, 32, and 64. Those are the size limits for your value. So if you have some number that is not that very huge, then you can use a 32. But if it's a small number, then you can use a 16. Like you want to order the value of 16, like any range between like maybe four bytes, then you can use a 16. But any number like 45,000, this is already I must use 32 bits. Okay, let me prove my fit. Let me prove it. So let me just use 16 and pass the value of salary in here. Then you see it will complain that I'm using a small size for a big number. So let's print it out. There we have console.write line. I'm going to use the same.format. I'll say amount is. So this is going to, since it's the first argument that I want to specify, then I will set it to 0, then colon N2. So with N2, it means that two decimal places. Then after the comma, there will be only two numbers after the comma. So that's why we say two decimal places. Okay. So then after here, then we need to pass our I salary. Okay. Believe that will be it. So there's no need for me to do so because it's going to be displayed as an integer. So it's not going to be double. So let me just leave it positive. Let's not that. So let's display the results. So you will see that it's going to complain that I'm using a small size for a huge number. Okay, you see, the value was either too large or too small for an int 16. So that would suggest me to use int 32. So I'm going to use int 32. Where was that? Okay. So we will change it to 32. So now it's problem solved. Come on. Here we go. So now we get our 45,001. So the reason why is because any number from any decimal places, any decimal number that starts from 5 and above, then it's going to be the number. It's going to be it's going to be rounded to the nearest number. Okay, so that's why we got 45,001, because this the first number that's after the decimal point was 7. So if it was 4, then it's still going to be, so if it was 48, then the feedback we will get 45,000, because the integer value does not have any decimal value. Okay, so only double and float that can have a decimal value. All right. Okay, let's create an example on user input. Our user input gave us an opportunity to allow the user to provide their own value. So the user is going to type in the value, and then later on we can use it within our program. So let's first display what we're expecting the user to type in or to provide. Then that will be console.write. All right. So if it's right line, then it's going to, after it write that particular string value on the console, then it will go to the next line. The cursor will go to the next line. But I don't want that. I just wanted to the cursor to wait on the same line, so that the user going to type in the information, so it's just going to be where we previously wrote to our console. So look here. So we can say enter your salary. Now let's all this value on this will be double salary equals to convert dot to double. The reason why I did that is because when you're reading from a console, it's going to hold the value as a string. We need to convert that string to a double. So let's see. And then this is going to be console.readline. And then bingo. So after that, we're just going to display our result, console.readline. String.format your salary is we specify 0.82. This will be salary. Believe that's it. Okay, let me see. Okay, we're just going to test it. Let's see the output. All right. Let's provide our value so we can say 50,000. Then we'll press enter. Then say your salary is 50,000. Right. Thank you guys. Please subscribe, share, and like the video. Bye.